Hello friends, in this video we are discussing about the manufacturing process of ceramics. Now talking about the manufacturing process of ceramics, how they manufactured in industry. In the process of manufacturing bricks, the following distinct operations are involved. First is preparation of your clay, then molding, then drying, then we go for burning, and last is glazing. So ceramic materials can be your tiles or any other materials. We have to go for this purposes, which are useful in bricks also. Only difference is we have added fifth step, that is your glazing. Then preparation of clay we have to do, then we have to go for molding for the size and shape, then we have to allow them for dry, then burning. Up to this the process is same as bricks, but the last is glazing. Now we'll discuss each and every step in detail. First is preparation of clay. The selected clay is made free from grit, pebbles, etc. Any clay which are useful for your preparation of ceramic materials will be chosen, and then they will be made free from any grit or pebbles present in it. Then this clay is then pressed and covered to fine powder in pug mills. Then this clay will be pressed and converted into the fine powder by using pug mills. They will be grind in pug mills by giving the excessive pressure so that they will get converted into the powder form, fine powder form. Then the mixture of superior quality of water and powdered clay is mixed in a tank and then allowed to stand still. Then they will be mixed with the water in a tank and they will be allowed to stand still. The coarse particle will be settled down. Because of standing still, the coarser particles will get what? Settled down. And the particles in suspension are taken in another tank. Then the remaining particles which are in suspension will be taken in another tank. All the water is allowed to dry and the fine clay left is used for manufacturing of tiles. In this way, we have to prepare the clay. First of all, what? We have to go for the selection of the clay. Then we have to remove the grit and pebbles from it. Then we have to press this and convert it into the fine powder in mills. After that, we have to mix this clay with water and allow the mixture to stand still, so that the coarser particle will get settled down. After which we have to take the fine particles, all the non-settled particles, and allow them to dry it off completely. Now the left clay will be used for the manufacturing of tiles. Now in next stage, that is molding. Now the clay is placed in molds which represent the pattern or shape in which tiles is to be formed. As we have seen the different types of form, they are coming in various shape and various sizes. So we have to go for the molding, we have to select the mold, and we have to represent the pattern and shape we require. The molds can be of wood, timber, iron, steel or plastic. Any type of wood you can use. The molds can be made by any available material in the market or the nearby areas. The clay is pressed into the molds by mechanical or hydraulic arrangements. Then the clay we have to press in the molds by using some mechanism, or we can use simply the hydraulic arrangements. This tile is removed from the molds and sent for drying. After this pressing of your molding clay in molds, will take out this tile and allow them for drying. Now the third step is drying. The tiles are then come out from the molds, are placed flat one above another in suitable numbers and dried for about 2 to 4 days. Same as construction of bricks here. We have to allow them for dry for 2 to 4 weeks in the stacks. The drying is generally done in shades to avoid warping and cracking of tiles because of excessive heat or directly exposed to your sun, it will develop the cracks also. So we should generally provide a shade in which the tiles should be dried off. The tiles become sufficiently hard and gain their shape, after which any irregularities in this shape due to vaporing are corrected by wooden metal and sent for burning. After drying, we have to check them for their shape and size. If anything is wrong, we have to correct it, and then and only then we can send them for burning. Now directly we cannot send tiles for burning, because of which what happened, they can get some deteriorated. So we have to first completely dry off the tiles, and then we can send them for burning. The tiles are burned in kilns, typically known as what? Silo-coated kilns. It is circular in shape and is protected by shades. It accommodates about 30,000 to 40,000 tiles, and burning is effective by firing wood placed in flues. So it is generally take 30 to 40,000 of tiles at a time, and we can manufacture this amount of tiles at a time. Heat regulation is very important to achieve better results. The heat is provided in the following ways. So heat is very important. We have to regulate the heat. We can't turn on the burner and provide the same amount of heat. So we have to regulate the heat, and it can be provided in following ways. The first, the fire is gentle in the beginning to remove all the moisture, that is up to 200 degrees Celsius for 1 hour, so that the extra moisture which is left after drying also will get removed completely. Then afterwards, it is then raised to a temperature of about 800 degrees Celsius and slack for 6 hours, after which the temperature is then raised to 1300 degrees Celsius, that is white heat, and kept constant for about 3 hours. So burning is done in 3 stages. First hour, it is 200 degrees Celsius for drying off excess of water. Then for next 6 hours, the temperature will be 800 degrees Celsius, and followed by the 3 hours of white burning, that is for 1300 degrees Celsius. The kiln is then gradually allowed to cool down to room temperature. The process of tile burning take about 72 hours for its completion, because storing, then burning, then cooling down will take 72 hours. A new technology called single firing technology is used nowadays, which result in drastic reduction in burning time. The burning time will get reduced by using this type of technology, which is known as also single firing technology. The burning time required is 1 hour with lower fuel consumption and cost of production. By using the single fire technology, the burning time is reduced up to 1 hour with consumption in your fuel also. So it is cost effective. Now talking about the last step, which is glazing. Definition is, the clay surfaces are sometimes glazed, that is what, glossy coat. Generally we have seen all the ceramic materials come with a glossy coating. So this glossy coat of 0.1 to 0.2 mm is applied on the surface and then fused into place by burning at higher temperature, so that the coat will get sufficiently stick onto your surface. The purpose of glazing are as under. Why we go for glazing generally for ceramic purpose? First, to improve appearance, will give you glossy look and it will look very good. Then to make articles impervious and durable. Next, to produce decorative effects. Generally it will give very good decorative effects. Then to protect articles from action of atmospheric agencies, chemicals, sewage, etc. And last is to provide a smooth surface. So generally we go for glazing over ceramic materials, so that they will give a very good appearance and they will make them durable. Also, it will protect them for atmospheric agencies, and they will give you provide very smooth surface. Now, there are two types of glazing. One is transparent and the second is opaque. Now, generally we go for transparent glazing. It is also salt glazing. A small quantity of NaCl, that is salt, is added in king at high temperature of about 1300 degrees Celsius, which vaporizes to give a glass-like finish. It will give you a glass-like finish. Your ceramic material will look like a glass. It will give you a glossy look. Then sanitary pipe and store wave. Then we generally use for quality of wet salt and throwing at proper time is to be done with extreme care. The article color is brownish. And for opaque glazing, this type of glazing is given for better appearances. A superior quality of clay is finely grind and subsequent quality of water is added to form plastic cream known as slip. So in this method, what we do? In this method, we use clay and we mix them with the water to form a paste which is known as slip. The articles are dipped in slip before burning and subsequently heated. So all this glazing is done before the burning. For your transparent, we do at the time of burning only. For in opaque, we have to do it before the burning. It results in opaque glazed surface. Sanitary articles are glazed with this process. The sanitary articles we are using, generally gully trap or your wash basin, are generally use opaque glazing. And other tiles material or articles we use for transparent glazing. Then next type is your lead glazing. The article after burning is dipped in oxide of lead and tin. The article is reburned at high temperature. The article of lead and tin melt and form a film of glass over the exposed surface. This method is superior to salt glazing. It is used for glazing terracotta, earthenware and fire clay wares. So this is another method, that is lead glazing using your transparent glazing. First is salt glazing and another is lead glazing. And lead glazing is superior to your salt glazing, for which we have to dip it into oxide lead and tin and then reburn it. And after reburning, after cooling, it will form a glass-like effect on your ceramic tiles. So in this video, we have discussed about what are the manufacturing process of tiles or your ceramic material. It is preparation of clay, then molding of clay, then we have to go for drying of tiles, after which we will go for burning, and burning is take place in kilns only. And last is glazing. Glazing is very important as it will give you good appearance and strength. Thank you.